All right, YouTube, we're gonna go into our second test shadow. God, I need to get rid of Nightbot. How are you doing there, Schlitz Cube, or Schultz Cubed? Is that how you would like that pronounced there, sir? God, we were kind of close to a trophy there. Stupid Mardu Pyromancer deck. How are you doing today, sir? Do you got rice cooking in the microwave? You got a 3-day beard? I don't plan to shave. That's a tune there. I don't think I have my music going on through that whole league. Dude, Philly's hype, man.
He's my boy.
Even though he might be eating my sandals.
You're not a good boy. Come on, buddy. Sit. High five. Good boy. Don't stay down. Sit. High five. Good boy. So don't stay down. High five. Don't stay down. High five. High five. Don't stay down.
Oop. My girl's going to bed today, so I'm off. How is she? What's she going to bed for? See, are you supposed to mulligan hands like this? It's like one, two. Yeah, we gotta mulligan this, right? You can't keep this. Alright, heater. We can sort of scry. Then opt the other turn. I guess we are opting. We're like slow trip opting. My opponent mulligan too, what a guy. We don't need another nasty gear nasty. That's another thing that frustrates me a little bit about this deck is that the threats are not good in multiples. Like if you draw like two anglers, that just feels gross. Okay, so now we're just gonna get a watery grave. Bravecto. I'm not sure if I'm familiar with the term. I'm not sure I'm down with the lingo. Alright, Snapcast on one land. Heater. Oh, I should have opted. I was looking over right here. Alright. So we're going to opt on our main phase. Because I might hit something sweet. I'm playing a mirror. Thought Scour is kind of sweet. We're going to put Thought Scour on top because it's going to enable our Delve cards. We're playing a good old-fashioned mid-range slugfest here. Okay, that makes sense. This is unfortunate. We're going to let this go. Yeah, in DC, we have a lot of water issues. So we get a lot of standing water and humidity. So Philly's got a special vaccine for like water problems. Alright, so I think we're just gonna untap here. No, tilt. Alright, let's. Thought Scour. Into a bobble. Well, we're definitely gonna just. We're definitely fetching no matter what. So, we want cards that matter. We don't have any Death Shadows left in our deck. We're going to take this Bobble out just in case our opponent has Tarnoif, which is like slim to none. Then I'm going to shock myself, and we're going to Bobble on our opponent's upkeep. Don't Liliana me. Creeping Tar Pit. I've lost a lot of games to Creeping Tar Pit. They don't have Terminate up, which is kind of cool. Then we're going to be able to start snapping getting the snap down here. So let's start by doing this. Let's get in here. And we're just going to pass the turn. My opponent Liliana has made this snap cast formation do some serious work. All right. I see what kind of game we're playing. You better have enough to kill me, dude. Okay, so now we're just going to go... Because Snapcaster is a two-turn clock. So we're going to go Snap Opt. We're looking for like a discard spell. If I get K-commanded here, I'm just going to ditch my Rage. This leaves me dead to double wall, so I think I'm actually gonna put this in the bottom. Another snap is gas. Alright. Seven you. Alright, Snapcaster Rage. What are you doing with this? We're gonna bolt this. Save my dismember for like a big scary Delph card. So you probably just bolt my face now. Then if he fires at this tar pit, I'm just gonna bolt Snapcaster. Okay. It's gonna mean a Jace is coming down, which would kind of make me like bummed out. Yeah, it's the only non... It's not great. It's the only non-copyright music I could find. They play Liliana. I'm just going to flash the Snapcaster Mage in. Okay, so they're going to Inquisition me. And then they have to take Battle Rage. No, my opponent's just dead. Because we flash Snapcaster Mage on the turn, untap, dismember this, clock them with either the Lightning Bolt or the Battle Rage. That's for the best. So my opponent's dead 6 ways to Sunday. Anyway, we cut it here. Because the Battle Rage kills them, or the Snapcaster Mage plus the Lightning Bolt kills them with the dismember. So either this one does, or these three combinations. My Battle Rage. Alright, so let's get Snappy Boy in on the end step. You know what I'm saying, Phil? Get some of that hot Snapcaster action. Yeah. You know about Snapcaster Mage, don't you? You know about Snapcaster Mage. Yes, Dad. Dad, I love Snapcaster Mage. Snap City, bitch. Right, my dog sits there and raps. Alright, so we're looking to settle in here for a bit of a long one. But it's a Snapcaster. Cards we're not interested in. Any of these Street Wraiths. This Battle Rage. And then 2 Fatal Pushes. That was easy. I want to keep in Dismember because they might have like some Taz Daddies. We want to be able to handle those. But I want to keep the bolts in to kill Jaces and Tar Pits. But now we're just going to sit down here and we are going to snuggle up for the long game, Phil. You know what I'm saying? I bet you look for the long game with all the pitchers, right? Get it? Because pitchers are female dogs. As long as you're not chewing, I will watch you. Your stream is unwatchable when you are chewing. Alright, we're gonna keep it. We're probably just gonna run this Pyromancer out on 2. Stub anything that we can possibly stub on 1. God, like, best case scenario, my opponent plays a Search for his Conta this turn. Or they go like dot season to tap land. They play like a bob, I'm gonna puke. Alright. We're just gonna stub that. No Liliana. As long as they don't Liliana me, I should be in pretty good shape here. Don't Liliana me. Even if they Liliana me, it's not that bad, actually. Alright, we're gonna discard this Death Shadow. Son of a bitch. I think I'm actually gonna hold on this Kolaghan's command, not doing the main phase. Because if my opponent plays a Jace, I wanna be able to stub it. I really don't wanna play against a Jace on an open field. So what happens if they counterspell this? If they counterspell this, like I'm up shit creek without a paddle. But they would need to be like mana leak. So I'm at least gonna get a card out of them. And I don't want them to just take this, and they're gonna take. They're obviously gonna take my Liliana last hope here, but I don't want them to like take my last hope, take my Kolaghan's command, that I'm not doing anything on my turn. I watch you all the time, Johnny. I literally tune in at like the beginning of every one of your streams. Okay, took my last hope. All right. So now we have ground out into the game where neither of us have anything. Guess. So I really don't want to use this Snapcaster Mage until I get one more land. Because I really want to start Snapcaster K commanding some homeboys. Back my Pyro, probably. I'm definitely regretting not shocking myself now. Cool thing, if they go to like kill this with a bolt, I can actually like snap, dismember my own Snapcaster. Which is definitely kind of mopey, but. If this is a discard spell, I'm just going to flash my Snapcaster Mage in and target Thought Scour and let him take my Stubborn Denial. Is this a delve? We delving? I think they're delving. They see me delving. Delve. Alright. He's going to explode. I should have played it beforehand. So we're probably gonna get back our young Pyromancer. Or I might get Death Shadow back because it's gonna turn on my Stubborn Denial. I feel like their last cards are Cryptic Command. No, it's definitely not a Cryptic Command now. What is this? Is this a K command? Oh my god, I'm gonna get so punished. They're activating the Tar Pit. Alright, we're totally gonna take this. Yeah, we're gonna take this trade. We'll definitely Stone Rain my opponent. And now, we're gonna snap K command, get back Young Pyromancer because of this EE. return target creature from your graveyard. Target player discards a card. And we could just smoke his EE, but I think I would rather just blank his EE by not having a one drop, making this like a sort of a 3-for-1. Yeah, we get a Snapcaster too. Coming in for dose, Margaritas. This is another reason I don't really like this card. It's because, like, you have to, what are they drawing? They're drawing a land. Because in order for this to work, you have to, like, have the thing on the battlefield and take a bunch of damage. Oh, there's that's nasty. That is nasty. Gurmasty, baby. Oh, damn. The damnation. What a rip, dude. That's some athletic shit from my opponent. I was so pumped. Right, well, at least we get... Give me a good 5-5. Okay, so I don't need the Bobble. I don't have Tasker, so it really actually doesn't matter what I leave in here. I should leave as many spells as I can in order to just give myself the option to do whatever I want. That's another thing. There are so many people that... There are so many people that, like, build their decks and think that they're, like, they own Death Shadow. They just don't. Like, I think the only decks that are... The only fair decks that are good against Death Shadow are ones that have... This Grixis Death Shadow deck, at least, are ones that have Lingering Souls in their main deck. If you don't have Lingering Souls in your main deck, you're a dog to Death Shadow. Because the deck's just so much more efficient than what you're doing here. Like, you just sit there and you operate on one mana and two mana. Well, the other deck needs to play like Cryptic Command. And I just get way too underneath there. I'm gonna just do this box plug again. So, my name's Dylan Hubby. I appreciate all you for watching and hanging out tonight. If you guys like what you see, please hit the like button or the follow button. That's the easiest way to get everybody so they can check out what I'm doing. If you want to support me further, go on to YouTube and subscribe to my YouTube page. It's free. It's, you know, it's just the best way to support me without opening up your wallet. Interact with me on Twitter. I love talking magic on Twitter. You know, love getting a little Twitter spats. And you guys check out my sponsors, which are GamerCraze. They are linked below. Their Crystal Commerce is cheap because they have a college environment. They need to make sure their college kids can play magic cards. And then Cardholder is the best blockchain in the business. So if you guys need magic online needs, just check out Cardholder. Alright, his hand's kind of gross, but I think I'm going to keep it. Well, we got two redraws and we get to scry with each one of them, so I think I'm going to keep it. What are you doing? It probably wasn't an adult decision keeping this. Hey, what are you doing? What are you doing down there, Filberson? Dead. I'm just messing around because you're not doing fun stuff with me, Dad. Go back to sleep. You were napping. You went to the dog park twice yesterday. Dude, my dog gets his ass kicked at the dog park every single time he goes. He's so puny and like he's a little shy. So the dogs come and play with him. And he's just like, But he likes playing with some of them. Like, there was this dog named Tater that was a poodle. A poodle mix. He was having a good time with Phil, because he was, like, small. But then, like, I could put him in, like, the little... What are you doing? Stop that. Hey, no. Wow, this is, like, the millionth time I've played this deck here. Alright, we don't want that. At least we have a Battle Rage, which is one of our, like, top cards. I think this is the third time I've played this deck in 7 matches. I'm going to leave this Bobble because it gives us a scry next turn. And I'm basically like, my play's locked in. Like, I'm gonna push this thing as soon as I get enough mana to, like, do stuff with it. Wow. I really hope my opponent just goes, like, land into, whatever it is. I hope they go land. We play Angler next turn also. just going to use our mana. So we're guaranteed fetching this turn. So I'm actually going to hold my bottle. So I can get a little bit of value out of it. Actually, 1, 2, 3, 4. I could just play the bobble and delve my whole graveyard and use this afterwards. Let's see what they're drawing. They're drawing a shaman in the pack. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. Yeah, I think I'm just gonna delve my whole. I don't have anything really good in my graveyard. Alright, we hit a stab, which is nice. My opponent concedes. It's a nasty Gurmasty. Alright, so I think I figured out how to sideboard, how I wanted to do this. I wanted to cut my Snapcasters. I wanted all of these cards here. And I think this is how we did it, boys and girls. The old Snapcaster Mage is just a bit too slow on the draw. We got a Lava Man. Lava Man's been like the MVP so far today. I've been really happy with Lava Man. So we have a Bolt. And a bunch of cantrips. I think we're gonna keep this. My opponent's Mulligan. But then Mulligan's kind of against my religion. This shows kind of weakness, I think, leading off of a cavern. Johnny, I'm never gonna let you down. If he doesn't have anything here, then I'm gonna opt. I'm not gonna bolt this. I'd much rather just... Actually, is it better to opt or to... I think it's better to opt because I'm looking for land specifically. And like, more than likely next time we're gonna have to tap out for nasty. And I don't really want to tap out this early in the game yet. All right, Thoughtseize is not what we're looking for. That is what we're looking for. So now I'm gonna get... Check out what's going on here. Alright, so this Renegade Leader is annoying. Basically all these cards are pretty annoying. And I think Lead the Stampede is the most annoying. So we're going to take that. Hopefully my opponent plays the Renegade next turn, and then I'll just bolt it, and then we'll untap, and we'll get nasty. I'm probably saving this bolt for this Renegade Leader. Oh, what a tilt. What am I looking for? I'm looking for discard. I'm gonna put that on top. We're gonna need mana. That's a pretty good draw. So now I can actually just go Death Shadow and Nasty. And then hold up just a bunch of bolts and just start mowing things down. We just need to like pray to God that our opponent doesn't like. I just hope they miss on a land. I definitely like this version a lot more. I've liked being lower to the ground. You know, I like Bobble plus Street Wraith in fetch land is good. Like, that's good. Dude, miss on a land drop. One time. I'm actually going to bolt this. Okay, so he's got more Elvish Mystic. So he's going to be able to play his Renegade Leader no matter what here. What I need to do is I need to bolt this Mystic in order to, like, constrict his mana. Because he's got two Heritage Druids. That doesn't matter. If we'd let that resolve, then he could have come to us. And then on our turn, we're going to bolt probably the Renegade Leader. There. And my opponent's gonna be able to company, but we're putting on, like, we're definitely putting a hurting on. So let's start by opting. We're looking for a discard spell. Fatal Push lets me go Bolt Push. Yeah, like that. So let's put this on the top. And then we can push this, and my opponent needs to rip in order to be able to cast company. When the threats are online with Grixis Shadow, this is just so gas. Like, when you hit your threats, like, it just feels like you can't lose. Blooming Marsh, into play tapped. What a tilt. Oh man, he's getting frisky. I want a Stubborn Denial or a removal spell. Alright, well, ask and you shall receive. Alright, opponent goes to two. There's no sense playing the land because they have to block the shadow anyways. Alright, I need to just make sure my dog's not eating things in my... whatever it is. We're just gonna go to combat, hold this. Alright, get out of my face. Two Stubborn Denials has felt like aces in this main deck here. Alright, I'm gonna make sure my dog's not just, like, eating all of my stuff. Hey, Phil Dog. Filmerson. I want to play against humans. Gilberson. Gilber Dog. Deck does a whole lot of nothing, but you can't mulligan a hand like this. Like, it kills shit, but this is a hand where it's just like, I guess because we have the stub, we... Alright. Here we go. Wow, that's a shit start for my opponent. We're definitely going to be on the slow train here, because hopefully my opponent just jams a... Okay, so we're going to kill any creature on the stack here. I don't think it's really worth stubbing that. So we're just gonna kill this. I think I'm gonna get a basic. Cause, like, we're gonna be able to turn on a Death Shadow whenever we want. Because of this dismember. Gonna pass. Phil Dog. Phil Dog, as soon as Dad's done, we're gonna go to the dog park. Oh god. Incoming Edge Champion. Should I stub this to stop an Edge Champion? At least one turn, then I can find a discard spell. Cause this has to be an Edge Champion's coming down. No, I don't think it's worth it. Show me your Edge Champion, dude. Hey, yeah, I've been busy there, Archmage. And I was a little bit under the weather. Alright, so we got a battle. I think we're gonna like check out my opponent's top card here. And then we're gonna get to Signal Pest. Alright, that's weak. And I think we're gonna get a body on the floor, on the field. I should have played a different land. So we're gonna Inquisition our opponent. Wow, they didn't jam the Etch Champion. Why did they jam the Etch Champion? Oh, they could. Well, no, they could. All right, dude, we'll take it. They have a Signal Pest. And we have Nasty Gurmasty, baby. I love Gurmag Angler. Dude, Gurmag Angler is just my boy. So I can actually just dismember this, then shock myself, and then hit Angler for one. And I think that's a good deal. Then I have double stub. So, like, we've got these Galvlasts covered. I want to put, like, in a relationship with Gurmag Angler. I just hope I hope we double Galvlast my build Nasty. Alright, we're not. I think with two Galvlasts. We have two Stubborn Denials now. Though I'd really like to be able to stub a. This is like 6-1 my head does together. Because I'd like to be able to stub. Yeah, I think we're just gonna play this tapped. I don't think we're gonna cycle this thing either. You got it. You got the first one. I will stub the second one. Bet your sweet ass, Bessie. Blinky. Getting in there. He's gonna give me the old upkeep blast action. Try to blast my. You can't be trying to blast my angler, right? You're just gonna try to slow the angler down. Alright. You should blast me right now. Don't let me look at another card. Alright, now we'll pass. So I guess we're kind of dead to like an Etch Champion. Not an Etch Champion, whatever that dumb card is. We're pretty dead to an Etch Champion, but we're super dead to a Ravager. There we go. Phil, what's your opinion on Nasty Gurmasty, bud? So now we're gonna opt for the old Lightning Bolts. It's right there. Put it on the bottom. Now I feel alright. Well, hang on. No, we let this go. We push this. And then we just don't get got. Okay, this is all good. We don't get got by a Galvlast. Give me that. All right, so we're gonna board in. We want all these threes, this, and this. We don't want these street wraiths. We probably don't even want as all these inquisitions. Got a couple Thoughtseizes, and then maybe like one Snapcaster, because we're not looking to play that long of a game. Maybe I should keep in like some Inquisitions and shave on an Angler, because we're gonna bring in Cutting Thoughtseize, because we're gonna bring in Lava Man. Lava Man's been aces. Like, let me tell you about a man that I love that is made out of lava. Probably should have cut my stubborn denials. Now they hit like cranial plating, which is a big game. I've already migrated, right? We did that. Wow, we are gonna get an aggressive Death Shadow going on here. We're gonna get a blood crypt. That Ravager out of my face. Okay, so that's what he drew. Okay, so Dismember down to 13, Fetch Shock down to 10. We still can't get this guy into play. Pretty pissed if my opponent plays like a Master of Ethereum.
Ooh.
I'd like to be able to do something with this, so I think we're gonna hold off. I could also play my Shadow and then have Lightning Bolt and bolt myself. I think that's the plan. And if my opponent gets frisky here, just send one upstairs. Bolt my face. One of the most scary things a Death Shadow player can say. I am not the biggest Lava Man fan, but I am certainly coming around on him. Alright, so we're gonna dismember this guy. And now we're just leaving mana up for the rest of the game. We're not gonna get punked by another Gal Blast or something like that. His deck felt good. Okay, so I know two out of their cards. I think I'm just gonna... I don't really want to put the shields down, so I think I'm just gonna bolt this and just keep chugging. I don't really want to tap out and command anything yet. Like, my opponent's got to answer what I'm doing here. Or they're just dead next turn. Okay, first one's good. Second one's not. Six ways to Sunday. All right. Three and out, man. It's been a good league so far. How's the chat doing? How is the chat life? Everybody having a good day? I'm having a great day. I got rice cooking in the microwave. I got a Philly dog who I love a lot. Philly, you got some goobers in your eyes, buddy. Hey, stop it. No biting. No biting. Okay, now, yeah, you don't like that. No biting.
Sometimes you gotta tell Philbert what's up. Sometimes he needs a little bit of aggro going in on him.
Gene Star Wind, I appreciate you for the follow there. I think it was a while ago, but. Alright, chat, we're gonna go say hi to Phil.
Hey, Philly. Say hi to everybody. Say hi. Say hi to everybody.
Nope. Don't eat the chat, bud. Don't eat the chat. He was trying to eat you guys. I think you gotta mulligan these kind of hands. Alright, heater. Kind of. It's potentially a turn to Death Shadow. My opponent gives me a target for this dismember. I swear to God, if he plays a slippery boggle, I'm gonna puke. You mother. At least we're going to be able to probably stub something here. I want to stub something that's relevant, but makes so, but like leave something that lets me put my Death Shadow into play. Just play a Core Spirit Dancer. Rancor. Alright, we're going to let that go, because it's going to let me get Shadow in. Alright, we're going to get that one out of here. I mean, I'm pretty sure that I'm about to get, like, Daybreak Coronet into the next year. But this cracks me for three. So the best way to win this matchup is to draw Team or Battle Mage. Best case scenario for us, our opponent plays a Core Spirit Dancer. Oh god, here comes the frickin' favorite corner. Alright, that's bad. And now we're just gonna take six. Yeah, we're just gonna take six here. At least our shadow's the biggest thing on the battlefield now. This is gonna hurt not having Liliana on the Veil. But such is life. We need something here. So I can trade one of my shadows for an Umbra. Let me see what they are drawing. You want a treat, Phil Dog? They're drawing a Spirit Mantle, which kills me. Tilt. Phil, they drew the Mantle. So against this deck, I want my stubs. I want Radiant Flames, because sometimes they keep hands that are, like, pretty sketchy. They've just got, like, a very, like, medium amount of interaction. Or, like, they mulligan, they keep, like, a ley line with a couple threats to play around the Liliana of the Veil, and they don't have a way to answer this card. And I'm going to cut an Angler, because they oftentimes bring in Rest in Peace. Probably should cut Snapcaster Mage. Yeah, I fucked up. All right, we'll get to the bobble trick. This hand is not good, but it's what we're gonna do. At least my opponent mulligan as well. All right, we're gonna need a battle rage to win this game. probably going to... So we got the tools now. Now we just need to like not get destroyed here. Show me your bogle. Show me your bogle. Bogle, 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 bogle. There's a bogle. I'd like to draw that Thoughtseize. Let me see what my top card is. Because I might Thoughtscour my opponent if my top card's good. There's another sweet Bobble interaction with Thoughtscour. Something that's kind of cool is that when you play Thoughtscour with Jace, you can Scalding Tarn. So we actually want that because it's going to let us get Shadow down this turn. Oh, we hit a rip. So this is gonna get blood ripped. So if we want to cast multiple red spells, we can. Plus, sometimes thought scouring your opponent's sweet because you can like mess with their draw. Play a rest in peace. All right. Alright, so now we gotta figure out how to kill him. Because I'm sure there's draws that we're at 7, they're at 15. We just shock Battle Rage and they're dead. Gas. Get out of my face. Well, bogle yourself! Get bogled. I do like this deck. Snapcaster's gonna be worse than the draw. Is Snapcaster worse than K-Command? Because K-Command can at least rebuy Street Wraith. Yeah, fuck these Snapcaster. We're gonna get linear here. If I will play this deck happily if I can find a configuration where I can just be like put my head down and tell my opponent to fuck themselves. I just like get out of my opponent's face. So this hand, stone unplayable if my opponent has a ley line, and after they snap kept so bad, I think I'm gonna mulligan. Alright, we're gonna get nasty at least. So, 1, 2, 3, 4. So I think we actually need to put this on top in order to get Angler into play next turn, right? So 1 plus 3 is 4. Yeah, so we gotta put this on top. Damn it, they didn't have a ley line. That means I get to at least Inquisition them. Now, we might not go pedal to the metal of the life total here, because we don't have a shadow. Alright, so do we just take this path, knock the top of our library, and they miss a land next turn? Yes. Don't play a land. You skeezball, you son of a... And it's like, we had to do that, right? Because, like, if we take the rest in peace, they just path our angler, we're not doing anything. God, just play Core Spirit Dancer. Damn it. Now we're gonna opt, and we're looking for just Death Shadow at this point. That's the only card that we give two shits about. and then we're gonna Thoughtseize away this court. We're gonna Inquisition away this Corpse Spirit Dancer. That was frustrating. I mean, dropping the Inquisition, we might have had a decent shot at this game. Death Shadow. That is literally all we care about at this point. Show me the shadow. Nope, we don't want that. We're literally just bottoming anything that's not a Death Shadow for like the rest of the game. Comes two morons. I'm gonna have to just restart Moto after this match. Oh, there are. Oh, they draw a Path to Exile. He drew a Path to Exile, man. Come on. Yeah, he did. Alright. Get rid of some of their crap. Go get an island. We got rid of a Griff Spoon. Alright, don't path me. One time, come on. Alright. Okay. Get in here. And then I'm just going to dismember this. Alright. The question is, how much damage am I taking? I would like to have my Death Shadow be 4 power. Be 8 power. So that's a 2 turn clock. So I can do that with my lands. We know they don't have another Glade Cutter Scout. Okay? Okay. So now they're coming in for 3. Show me a Battle Rage. One time. And I can fetch here because it's still lethal throughout a Battle Rage and we can at least lean our deck out a little bit. Show me a Battle Rage or a Radiant Flames. Alright, that's not it. So, if I attack, I'm dead to any... if I attack, I'm dead to any enchantment. I think we're gonna pass. At least we get to hold him off here. We're dead to a Spirit Mantle. Well, Spirit Mantle just gives pro creatures. Get the little defender. Little shadow that can play defense. Alright, block. Okay. Play this. I think we don't have another land, unfortunately. Yeah, we don't have 7 lands in our deck that actually make mana. So now we're looking for Battle Rage or Bust. Right now. Dryad Arbor, okay. Tilt. Oh man, we were so close. We were so close. And we ran bad. That, it would've been so nice to have that Angler up there. Alright, we're just gonna put the sponsorship page up here while I restart Modo. So, thank you all for showing up here. My name is Dylan Hubby, I'm part of the Card Hoarder Network. If you guys like what you see, please hit the follow button. And I appreciate y'all being here. If you wanna, like, support me without opening up your wallet, you can definitely check out my YouTube page. I archive all my streams on there. It's mostly Death Shadow stuff. I occasionally play other decks, but I've been strapped for time recently, so I haven't had the chance to. If you guys want to support me more, you should check out my the sponsors here, Gamer Craze. Gamer Craze is like an absolutely fantastic store in upstate New York. Their Crystal Commerce is linked below. They have like really good prices on cards because they foster a college environment. Card Hoarder is the best bot chain in the business. Between their team and their podcast, they're just their aces. And just check me out on Twitter. That's where I like to talk magic. But besides that, I appreciate you all being here. And I hope you're all having a good day. It's a Thursday. It's almost the end of the week. I hope everybody is just doing great today. I definitely like this bobble version of this deck. I wonder if it's right to play four bobbles or if three's enough. You know, most of the time I really don't like just going halfway or dipping my toe in. I like playing like four or nothing when it comes to strategy like that. Though I don't exactly know what I would cut. So I gotta kind of think about that a little bit. Yeah, there's a lot of snow going on. Alright, so we're back on here. What are you doing? You're just coming onto my stream and you're telling me what to do? Who do you think you are? Who do you think you are? Show some R-E-S-P-E-C-T. Tell you what it means. Nope, not this weekend. Nope, hanging out with the wife.
The old struggle.
My buddy Johnny Brissett in the chat also streams. If you like to look at some, like, if you like to look, watch Blue Decks in Modern. What's up his alley? Started out 9-3 at the GP this weekend. Just a good start. Had kind of a rough finish, but you know, starting out 9-3 is pretty gas. Right, Philly? 9-3 is gas, right?
Thank you.